गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ सोनल ब्राह्मणकर, केमिस्ट्री टीचर इन तुलजाराम चतुरचंद कॉलेज बारामती। अप टिल नाउ वी हैव कंप्लीटेड फोर टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम केमिस्ट्री। इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द टॉपिक रेडॉक्स रिएक्शन। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द टॉपिक नंबर 14, बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। दिस इज फर्स्ट टॉपिक of organic chemistry. So what is organic chemistry? We have seen branches of chemistry. Chemistry, it is broadly classified into four main branches. First branch, it is a physical chemistry. Second branch is inorganic chemistry. Third branch is organic chemistry. And fourth is analytical chemistry. So this topic comes from organic chemistry. So what is organic chemistry? We see in detail. Now let us start our topic. First we see introduction of this topic. What are compounds? In the first topic we have seen classification of matter. Matter, it is classified into pure substances and mixtures. In ancient time, minerals, plants and animals are the major sources of naturally occurring substances. So that pure substances are again classified into elements and the compound. So the compounds are again classified on the basis of source from which they are obtained. Compound firstly classified into inorganic compound and second organic compounds. So what are the inorganic compounds? Inorganic compounds, the source of inorganic compound, it is a non-living organisms. That means minerals are the source of the inorganic compound. So the compounds obtained from non-living organisms were called as inorganic compound. J compounds, non-living organisms pasun metat. अशा कंपाउंड्स ला इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स म्हणतात. सो व्हाट आर द एग्जांपल? सॉल्ट, NaCl, देन कॅल्शियम कार्बोनेट, कॉपर सल्फेट, दीज आर द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड. देन सेकंड टाइप ऑफ कंपाउंड्स आर ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. व्हाट आर द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड? व्हाट इज द सोर्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड? सोर्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड आर द लिव्हिंग ऑर्गॅनिझम्स. That are plants and the animal. The compounds obtained directly or indirectly from living organisms that are plants and animals were called as organic compounds. Ki ja compounds are source ha living organisms ahe, je compound plants and animals pasun mehtat, asha compounds la organic compounds mantat. Examples, eche baga, oils, then sugar obtained from the sugar cane, proteins obtained from plants, carbohydrates, then fats. So all these are the organic compounds that are obtained from plants and animals. So when organic compounds are studied, then it was realized that organic compound contains carbon as a main element. So in this topic, we shall learn basic principles required for understanding the formation and properties of the organic compounds. So organic compounds are important for our life, and the meaning of organic means the living. So what is the importance of organic compounds in our life? Now see the next point. Importance of organic compounds. Now see in detail. In the first food industry, our diet mainly contains carbohydrates, proteins, fats, then sweetening and the flavoring agents, milk, etc. All are the organic compound. Then second type of industry, pharmaceutical industry. Organic compounds are useful in pharmaceutical industry in preparation of medicines, synthetic drugs. Drugs means medicines. Medicines like ibuprofen, aspirin. That tablets control the body temperature. Then paracetamol, antibiotics, vitamins and the hormones. All that contains organic compound. Then the third type of industry, petroleum industry. Our energy resources that contain organic compounds, LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, is open garamade gas cylinder vaparto tyachyamadhye asto LPG, that also contain the organic compound, then gasoline, petrol, then kerosene, all that compounds are organic compounds. Then plastic industry. Plastics madhe suddha organic compounds are used to PVC, polyvinyl chloride, polythene, bakelite, etc. are polymers. त्यानंतर textile industry मध्ये पण organic compounds चा use होतो. Nylon, synthetic fibers आहे. Nylon, terylene, rayons are synthetic fibers. आणि natural fibers आहे. Cotton, silk, wool that are organic in nature. So in clothing also, organic compounds are important. त्यानंतर next type ची industry आहे 6 number fertilizer industry. Fertilizers मध्ये की जे आपण शेतामध्ये खत म्हणून वापरतो त्यामध्ये मेनली युरिया. युरिया इज एन इम्पॉर्टंट ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड. देन कॉस्मेटिक अँड परफ्यूम इंडस्ट्री. 7 टाइपची इंडस्ट्री आहे कॉस्मेटिक अँड परफ्यूम इंडस्ट्री. कॉस्मेटिक्स मध्ये परफ्यूम्स मध्ये क्रीम्स, टाल्कम पावडर, ऑल दॅट कंटेन्स ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. Then the next 8th one is organic molecules like the proteins. Proteins are the complex organic molecule that are the components of blood, skin, muscles and the hairs. So proteins are also the complex organic compound. Then next complex molecule like DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, enzymes, vitamins, lipids, carbohydrates that make our life. So organic chemistry plays very important role in our life. So organic compounds are very important. Now historically organic compounds that are obtained from plants and animals, but later on organic compounds prepared in the laboratory. So chemist tried here to synthesize the organic compounds in laboratory. Now which organic compounds prepared in the laboratory? See that organic compounds. The first organic compound synthesized in laboratory, that is a urea, by scientist Friedrich Holler in 1828. सर्वात पहिल्यांदा organic compound lab मध्ये तयार केलं गेलं. That compound it is a urea. How it is obtained? It is obtained from the inorganic compound ammonium cyanate, NH4CNO. When ammonium cyanate is heated, then urea is obtained. See the formula of urea, NH2C(ONH2). So the first organic compound obtained, that is a urea. Ya discovery nantar organic chemistry madhe vegvegle organic compounds se tayar kele gele laboratory madhe. So this discovery brought a revolution in the field of organic chemistry. So the second organic compound discovered in 1845 by scientist Kolbe. Second compound discovered acid. Then next, in 1856, the scientist Berthelot prepared the organic compound methane in laboratory. So later on, all the organic compounds that are prepared in the laboratory. So these are the organic compounds prepared in lab. So all that organic compounds contain carbon as the main element. And so the new branch of chemistry is developed, and that is the organic chemistry. So what is the organic chemistry? Organic chemistry means chemistry of carbon compounds. कि ज्या ब्रांच मध्ये कार्बन कंपाऊंडचा स्टडी केला जातो त्या ब्रांचला म्हणतात ऑर्गॅनिक केमिस्ट्री. सो ऑल द ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड कंटेन विच एलिमेंट? कार्बन एज द मेन एलिमेंट इज प्रेझेंट. बट दिस डेफिनेशन इट इज अ इनकम्प्लीट डेफिनेशन. ओनली द केमिस्ट्री ऑफ कार्बन कंपाऊंड, दिस डेफिनेशन इट इज अ इनकम्प्लीट बिकॉज देअर आर मेनी carbon compounds which are inorganic in nature. So which are that inorganic compounds? For example, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, calcium carbonate and carbon disulfide. All these compounds contain carbon element, but that compounds are inorganic in nature. Now what is the reason behind that? So reason is, here no bonding between carbon and hydrogen. So organic compound contains carbon as the main element, but it is also associated with the hydrogen. That means organic compounds are the hydrocarbon, but here no any hydrogen atom is present. And carbon hydrogen bond, what is the reason? Carbon hydrogen bond has a lower bond energy than the carbon oxygen bond. So this carbon monoxide becomes more stable and it is less reactive than the typical organic compound. Organic compounds, they contain carbon hydrogen bond and that are more reactive compounds. So what are the organic compounds? Organic compounds are the hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbon means hydrogen and the carbon. That are called as hydrocarbon, compounds of carbon and hydrogen. What is the simple definition of hydrocarbon? They are the compounds of carbon and hydrogen are called as hydrocarbons. Now, again, carbon and hydrogen are the present here, but large number of organic compound contains oxygen also, nitrogen, sulfur and halogens. So organic compound contains the element carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur and the halogens. So what is the new definition of organic chemistry? Chemistry of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. So what is organic chemistry? Organic chemistry, it is a branch of chemistry that deals with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives is called as organic chemistry. So in this chapter, we have to study the organic compounds. We have to study the hydrocarbons. Now let us start with the second point from the introduction, characteristics of organic compounds. Now the first characteristic, it is the composition. What is the composition of organic compound? We are seeing organic compound contains which element? Main element, it is the carbon as the main element. What is the symbol of carbon? It is represented as a capital C. So carbon as the main element, then hydrogen, along with that carbon, it is associated with the hydrogen, then oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, halogens and phosphorus. So these elements are present in organic compound, that is called as the composition. Composition manje tyachyamadhe aslele ghatak padarth. Okay, the organic compound contains carbon as the main element, then hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, halogens and phosphorus. That is a composition of organic compound. Then the second characteristic is tetravalency of carbon atom.
टेट्रा वैलेंसी ऑफ कार्बन. What is the symbol of carbon? Carbon is written like this, having the atomic number 6. Its electronic configuration, how the electronic configuration is written? It is written as 2nd4. Okay. So, valence shell or this outermost shell contains 4 electrons. So, to complete the octet, octet means to complete 8 electrons in the outermost shell. Octet means इट इज अ स्टेबल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिग्रेशन कि कुठल्याही इलेमेंटला स्टॅबिलिटी अचीव करण्यासाठी त्याच्या आउटरमोस्ट शेलमध्ये किती इलेक्ट्रॉन्स असावे लागतात 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो टू कम्प्लीट द ऑक्टेट यर हाऊ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर रिक्वायर्ड यर ओनली द 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर रिक्वायर्ड यर. ओके ना हाऊ दॅट 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर पॉसिबल यर आयदर दॅट 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. Okay, so there is no possibility of gaining the electrons or losing the electrons here. Okay, carbon atom 4 electron घेऊ शकत नाही किंवा 4 electron हा देऊ पण शकत नाही कारण की त्यासाठी लागणारी एनर्जी या व्हॅल्यू कशा आहेत हाय. सो दॅट व्हॅल्यूज आर आयोनायझेशन एन्थाल्पी ऑर द इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एन्थाल्पी. दॅट व्हॅल्यूज आर व्हेरी हाय अँड दॅट्स वाय यर कार्बन ॲटम इथे इलेक्ट्रॉन देणार पण नाही किंवा इलेक्ट्रॉन घेणार पण नाही. सो कार्बन ॲटम कॅन शेअर सीट 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन. कार्बन ॲटम काय करणार आहे त्याचे 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन हा शेअर करणार आहे. हियर दिस इज अ कार्बन ॲटम 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो कार्बन ॲटम शेअर द 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन. वी टेक हियर द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ हायड्रोजन. हायड्रोजन इलेक्ट्रॉन दॅट आर रिप्रेझेंटेड बाय द क्रॉस अँड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ऑफ कार्बन दॅट आर रिप्रेझेंटेड बाय द डॉट हियर. ओके ना हाऊ कार्बन कॅन शेअर हियर द 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. कार्बन काय करणार आहे इलेक्ट्रॉनची भागीदारी इथे करणार आहे. ओके सो कार्बन हायड्रोजन हायड्रोजन. ओके सो द इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑफ कार्बन शोन बाय द डॉट हायड्रोजन शेअर इट इलेक्ट्रॉन. वन इलेक्ट्रॉन शेअर्ड बाय द हायड्रोजन ॲटम. 4 हायड्रोजन ॲटम शेअर्स 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन हियर. This is the electron of hydrogen atom. This is the electron of carbon atom here. Okay. Now, outermost shell of this carbon atom. When carbon shares its electron with the hydrogen atom, then this outermost shell of carbon atom contains how many electrons? These are the 4 and again these are the 4. So, total valence electrons are 8 valence electrons are there. How many electrons? 8 valence electrons. That means carbon atom completed their octet and here electrons are shared. Hydrogen shares 1 electron, carbon shares 1 electron. So the formation of single bond between the carbon and hydrogen. So this bond is formed here. That bond is called as covalent bond. It is formed by sharing of electrons, mutual sharing of electrons. Hydrogen atom shares 1 electron. Carbon atom shares 1 electron. So here the single covalent bond is formed between the carbon and hydrogen atom. In the similar way with the second hydrogen atom, in the similar way with the third hydrogen atom and with the fourth hydrogen atom. So in this way carbon atom can form 4 covalent bonds with the 4 hydrogen atoms. That's why valency of carbon atom. What is the valency of carbon atom? Valency of carbon atom, it is a 4 and that's why carbon, it is a tetravalent element. Tetravalency. Tetra means 4. What is the valency of carbon atom? 4. How it is obtained? We are shown by this formation of covalent bond with the 4 hydrogen atom. Carbon's atomic number 6. There's an electronic configuration 2, 4. Or we can write the electronic configuration also like this 1s2, 2s2, 2px1, 2py1 and 2pz orbital. It is an empty orbital. Okay. Now here only the 2 unpaired electrons are there. Okay. But the valency of carbon atom is 4. So when covalent bond formation takes place, then carbon atom absorbs some energy and It is going toward the excited state. So the electronic configuration, this is the electronic configuration in the ground state and the electronic configuration in excited state. What is the electronic configuration becomes? One of the electron from the 2s orbital, it is promoted to the 2pz orbital, 2s1, 2px1, 2py1 and 2pz1. So how many electrons are available here? 4 electrons are available here. And that's why here 4 unpaired electrons are available and carbon atom can form 4 covalent bonds. So what type of bonding is present in organic compounds? Covalent bonding is present. Already we have seen the bonding. दहावी पर्यंत तुम्ही बॉन्ड शिकलेले असाल. बॉन्डचे दोन टाइप्स तुम्हाला माहिती, आयोनिक बॉन्ड आणि कोव्हॅलंट बॉन्ड्स. ओके, आयोनिक बॉन्ड्स दॅट आर प्रेझेंट इन इनऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड अँड कोव्हॅलंट बॉन्डिंग दॅट इज प्रेझेंट इन ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड. सो हियर कोव्हॅलंट बॉन्डिंग इज फॉर्म्ड बाय द कार्बन ॲटम, सो बाय म्युच्युअल शेअरिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो व्हॉट इज द व्हॅलन्सी ऑफ कार्बन ॲटम? व्हॅलन्सी ऑफ कार्बन ॲटम इट इज द 4 and that's why carbon is tetravalent element. Now the third property of organic compound is catenation property. CATENATION. What is the catenation? Self-linking property of carbon atom is called as the catenation. See the definition. The ability of carbon atom to combine with one another to form long chains, branch chains and rings. कि यामध्ये कार्बन ॲटम हा स्वतःशीच बॉन्ड तयार करतो. ओके, आणि त्याच्यापासून तयार होतात लॉन्ग चेन्स किंवा ब्रांच चेन्स किंवा रिंग्स तयार होतात. दॅट प्रॉपर्टी इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ कॅटनेशन प्रॉपर्टी. दिस इज अ युनिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द कार्बन ॲटम. वाय इट इज युनिक प्रॉपर्टी? ऑल ऑफ यू व्हेरी वेल नो ग्रुप नंबर 14 एलिमेंट्स. In group number 14, which elements are present? Carbon, silicon, germanium and the tin. These elements are present in group number 14. But among that group 14 elements, carbon element having the maximum catenation property, then the silicon, then the germanium. So carbon atom that having maximum catenation property, then the silicon, then the germanium. And that's why here the catenation property, it is shown by the carbon atom. Now what is the actual catenation property? How we can form the chains? See that chain, carbon atom, it can form the bond with itself and form long chain. It can form long chain. This is a linear chain of carbon atom. Continuously carbon atoms are bonding ekmekanshi honare and that can form the long chain of carbon atom. Then it can either form ब्रांच कंपाउंड्स. इथे ब्रांच तयार होऊ शकते कार्बन ॲटमची ब्रांच. ओके, आयदर इट कॅन फॉर्म टू ब्रांचेस. ओके, सो इन दिस वे इट कॅन फॉर्म दी ब्रांच चेन कंपाऊंड. जसं एखाद्या झाडाला फांद्या फुटतात त्याचप्रमाणे इथे कार्बन चेनला काय झालेलं आहे? ब्रांच. दिस इज कॉल्ड ॲज दी ब्रांच, कार्बनची ब्रांच. ओके, नाव हियर द सिंगल ब्रांच इज देअर. नाव इन्स्टेड ऑफ दॅट इट कॅन फॉर्म 4 branches also. Okay, every time carbon atom satisfies its 4 valency. Okay, so this is a branch chain compound, this is the linear chain compound. Then third, it can form long chain, branch chains and also it can form the rings. Okay, rings are also formed here and that rings, see here the ring of carbon atom, here the 3 carbon atoms are joined here. Okay, how many carbon atom? 3 carbon atom. So this is a ring is formed here of 3 carbon atom. Then also it can form the ring of 4 carbon atom. So this is a 4 carbon atom ring here. Then also it can form the ring of the 5 carbon atom. This is a 5 membered ring. Okay. Then it can also form 6 membered ring. So these are the rings of different sizes. Carbon atom can form the linear chain, carbon atom can form the branch chain and also the rings. So this ability टू बॉन्डिंग विथ इट्स सेल्फ, तो स्वतःशीच बॉन्ड तयार करू शकतो. दॅट ॲबिलिटी इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ कॅटेनेशन प्रॉपर्टी. दिस इज अ युनिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कार्बन ॲटम. ओके, नाव इन द सिमिलर वे कार्बन ॲटम कॅन फॉर्म द बॉन्ड विथ कार्बन ॲटम कॅन फॉर्म द सिंगल बॉन्ड. ओके, नाव इन द सिमिलर वे कार्बन ॲटम कॅन फॉर्म द डबल बॉन्ड. ओके, and also carbon atom can form the triple bond also. Okay, so covalent bonds, they are of three types: single covalent bond, then double covalent bond, and the triple covalent bond. Single, then double, and the third one is a triple covalent bond. So here carbon atom can form the single bond, then carbon atom can form the double bond, carbon atom can also form the triple covalent bond with the same atom, and also it can form with the other atoms also: carbon nitrogen single bond, then carbon nitrogen bond, and also carbon triple bond nitrogen. Now here the nitrogen atom is taken, instead of that oxygen atom is also taken. Carbon form single bond with the oxygen, carbon atom can form double bond with the oxygen, carbon atom can form triple bond with the oxygen atom. So in this way carbon can form bond. Which type of bond? Covalent bonding is present in organic compounds, and carbon atom can join with each other, and that property, it is a catenation property. This is the self linking property. Ki ha swatashis bond tayar karu shakto, tya property la mantat catenation property. Okay, now see the valency distribution. How the valency of carbon atom, that is a four valency, is distributed among the atoms of other element. Now see the first case here. Okay, here the carbon atom, then it can form the four covalent bonds with different elements. So in this way here carbon atom can form the bonds with different elements. Here A, B, C, D are the different element, and here single covalent bond is formed here. Then the second possibility is, what is the second possibility here? Carbon atom can form double bond with any one of the element and form single bond with other elements. So carbon atom, what is the valency? 1, 2, 3, and 4. It can form double bond with other element also. Okay, this is the second possibility. Then the third possibility is, what is the third possibility here? Carbon atom can form triple bond with other element. Carbon atom kay form karu shakto? Triple bond tayar karu shakto. And here the other atom is different atom, B element. So here the four valency is satisfied. 1, 2, 3. Three bonds with other one atom and one bond with the one atom. So in this way four valency is satisfied of the carbon atom. Then the fourth possibility is, what is the fourth possibility? Carbon can form two double bonds. Here the first double bond is formed, and the second possibility is with the other element. So in this way valency is distributed by four cases. It can form single covalent bond, or it can form double bond with the one atom and two bonds, two single covalent bonds with the two different atoms. Then here triple bond is formed, or either two double bonds may be formed. Always carbon atom satisfies its four valency. So in this way it can form four bonds with other atoms or with same atoms. Now these are the other characteristics of organic compounds. First, fourth one is the isomerism. आयसोमेरिझम कन्सेप्ट जो आहे तो तुम्हाला पुढे दिलेला आहे, तो तिथे आपण डिस्कस करणार आहोत. ओके, त्यानंतर नेक्स्ट आहे पॉलिमरायझेशन. पॉलिमरायझेशन, कार्बन ॲटम कॅन फॉर्म द लॉंग चेन्स, अँड दॅट्स वाय इट कॅन फॉर्म द पॉलिमर्स. पॉलिमर मीन्स सिंगल मॉलिक्युल दॅट कंबाइन टुगेदर अंडर सर्टन कंडिशन, हाय टेम्परेचर अँड हाय प्रेशर. देन दॅट सिंगल मॉलिक्युल, large number of that molecule combined together and form the polymer. That process is called as the polymerization. So So here n number of molecules combine together and form the polymers. पॉलिमरायझेशन प्रोसेस मी तुम्हाला मगाशी सांगितलं की प्लास्टिक इंडस्ट्रीमध्ये ऑर्गेनिक कंपाऊंड्स आर युजफुल आहेत. ओके, सो पॉलिमर्स दे आर फॉर्म. एक्झाम्पल्स पॉलिव्हिनिल क्लोराईड असेल, पी व्ही सी पाईप्स असतील. ओके, किंवा याच्यामध्ये पॉलिथिन तयार होणारं पॉलिथिन आपण ज्या कॅरी बॅग्स यूज करतो दॅट आर दी पॉलिमर्स. सो दिस इज द पॉलिमरायझेशन कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड. देन नेक्स्ट वन इज अ सोल्युबिलिटी. ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड मधलं बॉन्डिंग मी तुम्हाला सांगितलंय की कोव्हॅलंट बॉन्डिंग इज प्रेझेंट इन ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड, सो दॅट कोव्हॅलंटली बॉन्डेड कंपाऊंड आर इन सोल्युबल इन वॉटर. दॅट आर सोल्युबल इन दी ऑर्गॅनिक सॉल्व्हंट्स बेन्झिन, क्लोरोफॉर्म, इथर, अल्कोहोल, दॅट आर सोल्युबल इन ऑर्गॅनिक सॉल्व्हंट्स. देन नेक्स्ट वन इज अ होमोलॉगस सिरीज. होमोलॉगस सिरीजचा पॉइंट आहे आपल्याला नेक्स्ट याच्यामध्ये बघायचा आहे. ओके, त्यानंतर नेक्स्ट आहे मेल्टिंग पॉइंट अँड दी बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. ॲज ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड्स आर कोव्हॅलंट इन नेचर, सो दे हॅव्हिंग द लो मेल्टिंग पॉइंट अँड लो बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. आयोनिक कंपाऊंड्स दे हॅव्हिंग दी हायेस्ट मेल्टिंग पॉइंट अँड हायेस्ट बॉइलिंग पॉइंट, बट कोव्हॅलंटली बॉन्डेड कंपाऊंड्स हॅव्हिंग लो मेल्टिंग पॉइंट अँड लो बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. नाईन कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टी इज कंबस्टिबिलिटी. Combustible means they are highly flammable compounds. तुम्हाला सर्वांना माहिती आहे डिझेल, पेट्रोल, त्याच्यावर आपण जळती काडी जर टाकली तर ते लगेच पेट घेतात. सो ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड्स आर हायली कंबस्टिबल कंपाऊंड्स. देन लास्ट वन इज अ फंक्शनल ग्रुप. फंक्शनल ग्रुप ही सुद्धा कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टी आहे ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंडची. प्रत्येक ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंडला एक ठराविक ग्रुप ऑफ ॲटम्सचा जॉईन आहे. That is called as the functional group. Next point मध्ये आपल्याला डिस्कस करायचे फंक्शनल ग्रुप. ओके, सो आयसोमेरिझम, देन होमोलॉगस सिरीज अँड फंक्शनल ग्रुप, दीज थ्री कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक वी हॅव टू स्टडी इन डिटेल. आता हा जो पॉइंट आहे कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड हा आपल्या टेक्स्टबुकमध्ये आत्ता दिलेला नाही, बट दिस इज द इंट्रोडक्शन टू दी ऑर्गॅनिक कंपाऊंड आणि म्हणून हा पॉइंट मी तुम्हाला सांगितलेला आहे. ओके, त्यानंतर आपण नेक्स्ट पॉइंट घेणार आहोत अँड दॅट इज द हायड्रोकार्बन्स. सो व्हॉट आर दी हायड्रोकार्बन्स? दी कंपाऊंड्स हायड्रोकार्बन्स. सो हायड्रोकार्बन्स आर क्लासिफाईड इन टू टू टाईप्स, सॅच्युरेटेड हायड्रोकार्बन्स अँड अनसॅच्युरेटेड हायड्रोकार्बन्स. सॅच्युरेटेड हायड्रोकार्बन मीन्स कंपाऊंड्स कंटेनिंग कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड कार्बन are called as saturated hydrocarbons and that are called as alkanes. They are called as alkanes. Then second type, unsaturated hydrocarbons, they contain carbon double bond carbon or carbon triple bond carbon. When carbon double bond carbon is present, then that compounds are called as alkenes. And when carbon triple bond carbon is present, that compounds are called as alkynes. Okay, valency of carbon atom is 4. Okay, so in this way, here alkenes and alkynes. Already in 10th standard, you have studied these compounds. When carbon single bond carbon, that compounds are called as alkenes. When carbon double bond carbon is present, that compounds are called as alkenes. And when carbon triple bond carbon is present, that compounds are called as the alkyne. So unsaturated hydrocarbon means double bond or triple bonded compound. Now we see what is the alkane family, what are the members of the alkane. So what is the alkane family? See here the alkane family. Alkane family. You can open your notebook and write the alkane family. Okay, so alkanes, what is the general formula of alkane? Alkane having the general formula CnH2n plus 2. What is the n? N means number of carbon atoms. So depending on that number of carbon atoms, number of hydrogen atoms are there. Okay. So when N is equals to 1, so what is the first member from the alkane family? Here the number of carbon atoms are 1. And hydrogen atoms, 2 into 1 plus 2. Okay. So the number of hydrogen atoms are 2 plus 2, 4. So the formula is CH4. And the name of the alkane is methane. Then second member, when N is equals to 2, what is the formula? Right here, put here the value of N as a 2, here 2. Then by multiplying, the formula comes C2H6. That is the second member, ethane. Ending is A-N-E. Okay. Then when N is equals to 3, then what is the formula? C3. Okay. 3 2s are 6. 6 plus 2, A. So C3HA. That is called as propane. Propane. Then when N is equals to 4, then C4. H 4 2s are 8 and 10. C4H10. That is called as butane. Then next member, when N is equals to 5, then C5H12, it is called as pentane. Okay, so methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane. Then the next member, when N is equals to 6, then the formula is C6. Number of carbon atoms are 6. Hydrogen atoms are H14. That is called as hexane. 6 for hexane. Okay. Then when N is equals to 7, then C7. H 7 2s are 14 plus 2. That is 16. So that is called as heptane. Then when N is equals to 8, then C8, 8 2s are 16 and 2 18, C8H18, it is called as octane. Then next member, when N is equals to 9, then C9, H 9 2s are 18 and 2, 20. So it is called as the nonane. Then next member, when N is equals to 10, then C10, H 10 2s are 20 and 2, C10, H 22, it is called as decane. So this is the alkane family. When N is equals to 1, methane. When N is equals to 2, ethane. Then propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane, and the decane. So in this way, this is the alkane family. Now the next members from the alkane family are, see the members, C11, H24, it is called as undecane. Then C12, H26, that is dodecane. Then C13, H28, it is called as tridecane. Then C14, H30, it is called as tetradecane. Okay, put only the number of carbon atoms in general formula and you can write the number of hydrogen atoms. Then C50H32, that is called as the pentadecane. Then C16H34, that is called as hexadecane. Hexadecane. Then next, C17H 36, it is called as heptadecane. Then C18H 38, it is called as octadecane. Then C19H 40 is called as nonadecane, and C20H 42, it is called as eicosane or icosane. Okay, so in this way we have written the alkane family up to the 20 number of carbon atom. Okay, so in this way we can also extend up to 30, 40 and 50 carbon atom. So these are the saturated hydrocarbons that contain carbon single bond carbon. Now in the similar way we can write the unsaturated hydrocarbon. So see that unsaturated hydrocarbons. In unsaturated hydrocarbons, first the alkene family. Alkene family means carbon double bond carbon is present. So the first member is C double bond C. Between the two carbon atoms, double bond is present. Valency of each carbon atom, it is 4. So the first member is CH2 double bond CH2. It is called as the ethene. Only the ending is ene. Okay. And eth for the two carbon atoms. Then the next CH3 between the three carbon atoms. CH3 CH double bond CH2. It is called as the propene. It is called as the propene. Then next, containing the four carbon atoms, how we can write the four carbon atom? What is the formula of that? C4. Okay, so the general formula of alkene family is CnH2n. Okay, so when two carbon atoms are present, n is equal to 2, then hydrogen atoms are double. So what is the formula becomes of ethene? C2H4, that is the ethene. C2H4, it is the ethene. What is the formula of propene? C3H6, that is the formula of propene. Then C4H8, that is the butene. Okay, then C5H10, it is the pentene. C5H10, it is a pentene. Okay, so in this way we have written the alkene family. You can extend up to the 10 carbon atoms also. So remember this general formula, CnH2n. This is the general formula of alkene family. Then the next family, it is the alkyne family. Alkyne family. These are the unsaturated hydrocarbons containing carbon triple bond carbon. So general formula of alkynes, it is CnH2n-2. This is the general formula of alkynes. Okay, so two carbon atoms, C2. Okay, number of hydrogen atoms are 2 into 2, 4. 4 minus 2, 2. So C2H2. This is the first member from the alkyne family and it is called as ethyne. What is the ending? Yne, it is the ending. Then next member, C3. Number of carbon atoms are 3. 3 2s are 6, 6 minus 2, 4. Okay, 3 2s are 6 minus 2, 4. So C3H4, it is called as the propyne. Containing 3 carbon atom, it is called as the propyne. Then C4, containing the 4 carbon atoms. 4 2s are 8, 8 minus 2, 6. So C4H6, that is called as the butyne. Then next member, C5. Number of carbon atoms are 5. N is 5. 5 2s are 10. 10 minus 2, 8. So C5H8. That is pentyne. Ending is YNE. Okay. So this is the alkyne family. You can exchange up to 10 carbon atoms. So this is the alkene family and this is the alkyne family. These are the unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay.